Hello students, welcome to my Science English Medium lesson series for grade 7 students by Ms. P. Arulmoli, St. Joseph's College, Trincomalee. First of all, I would like to thank our principal, Reverend Father Alfred Vijay Kamalan OMI, for giving me full support to make this video. Mr. P. Lojidan, teacher who helped me to make all the practicals as videos. Mr. Fahir, laboratory assistant. In this chapter, we are going to see about acids and bases available in school laboratory and the functions of indicators in laboratory. Objectives. At the end of this lesson, you will be able to say the examples for laboratory acids, bases and indicators. List out the color changes of each indicators with acids, bases and neutral substances. Children, shall we learn something about acids and bases available in our school laboratory? Okay, first of all, let's talk about acids. Have you ever seen the acids in our school lab? Yeah, you would be seeing some acids on our table in the laboratory. For example, sulfuric acid, nitric acid, hydrochloric acid. These are the acids frequently used in our laboratory. They will be diluted and labeled on a bottle. Here are some bases frequently used in laboratory. For the examples, sodium hydroxide and potassium hydroxide. These are the substances. They are white in color. You can see in crystal forms. When you keep in the air, you can see they are hydrated. When you take it in your hand, you can feel the slippery or soapy nature of those substances. Now we will see about the indicators in school laboratory. Already we have learnt about the indicators. Indicators are the substances change their colors with acidic and basic substances. The laboratory indicators are phenolphthalein, pH paper, methyl orange and litmus paper. You know there will be two colors of litmus paper, red and blue color. Likewise, phenolphthalein is a white color powder. When it is dissolved in water, it will be colorless. And the methyl orange is orange color powder. PH paper is yellow color, but it can be changed its color when we put into acids or bases. Let's enjoy the demonstrations related with acids and bases. Now let's see laboratory acids, bases and indicators. These are the laboratory acid, hydrochloric acid and sulfuric acid. These are the bases, sodium hydroxide and calcium hydroxide. These are the laboratory indicators, phenolphthalein solution, methyl orange, red litmus, blue litmus and pH paper. Now let's use litmus paper and pH paper to identify whether these substances acids or bases. First of all, I am going to put blue litmus paper into these two solution. You can see the observation in first solution, the blue litmus changed as pink color. Here you cannot see any observation. Now I am going to put red litmus paper into these two solutions. You cannot see any observation in first solution. You can see the red litmus paper changed as blue color. Now I am going to put yellow color pH paper into these two solutions. The first one changed as light orange color. The second one changed as blue color. From this activity, you can come to the conclusion. Blue litmus paper changed as red litmus in acidic substances. The blue red litmus changed as blue color into basic substances, and the color changes of pH paper also you could observe. Children, have you enjoyed this activity? Okay, three indicators were used here. You were able to see the color changes clearly. Here the observations are tabulated in a table. You can see the observation clearly. Let's see the activity for the function of phenolphthalein and methyl orange indicators. Now let's use the indicators in laboratory. This is phenolphthalein solution. This one is methyl orange. Phenolphthalein solution is colorless. Methyl orange solution is orange color. It was already prepared by me. Now I am going to add methyl orange solution into hydrochloric acid. You can see the color change here. Yeah, you can see the acidic substances changed as red color with methyl orange solution. Likewise, I am going to add some methyl orange solution into sodium hydroxide solution. Now you can see the basic substances changed as yellow color. Now I am going to use phenolphthalein solution. I am going to add phenolphthalein solution into acidic substance. There is no color change. You can't see any color change. But when we add phenolphthalein solution into sodium hydroxide solution, you can see the pinkish purple color. Children, the color changes of indicators phenolphthalein and methyl orange with acidic and basic substances are tabulated here. You can see pH paper is one of the indicator. The color of pH paper is yellow, but we can see various color when we put into acidic, basic or neutral substances. The color of pH paper are ordered in number. We can see that colors 1 to 6 when we put into acidic substances. When we put into basic substances, we can see the range of 8 to 14. When we put into neutral substances or water, we can see the color of 7.